Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and one of the things we do over on my YouTube channel is post a bunch of 2D prints that we challenge the audience to turn into 3D models. And one of those challenges was this one here, the egg cover cap. And I looked down in the comments and saw that Michael wrote, "Would love an Onshape tutorial on this one." Well, Michael, your wish is my command. Let's get into Onshape and see what we would do to turn this 2D print into a 3D model.
Ow!
All right, so let's hit play here on the video so we can keep the timer going. That way we can keep track of how long it takes us to create this thing. And one thing that I noticed when I hit this video to start is that the timer up here is actually covering up one of the dimensions. This is supposed to be 125 to match the 125 down here. So I do apologize for that. That is kind of a key dimension that ended up getting covered up there. So I'm sorry about that, everybody. But hopefully you were able to infer the 125 from this dimension down here and realize that it is the same. The other thing that I noticed on this model is that this 160 here in the top view is great. It's defined properly and it gives us a nice profile that we can revolve to 180 degrees. But when we look at the front view, we see that 160 is not really as clearly defined, and it certainly could be confusing if you were thinking that that should maybe be a loft or a sweep or some other solution to this model. But no, the solution for this one is going to be a revolve. You're going to want to create the first sketch here on the top plane using these driving dimensions. And then once you have that basic sketch there, you'll be able to do a revolve, revolve that 180. That'll give you the bulk of the egg. Then you're going to get in and do some kind of a shell command to hollow this thing out. And then either cut this wall down, or more likely we will extrude this wall from the bottom using a sketch like so, and then extruding that in Onshape. Then I think probably what I would do is create this boss extrude here using a circle and extruding it down. It doesn't look like that circle has any draft, so it's just going to extrude straight down here from this view. And then I think I'll finish up by creating these ribs. These ribs look like they're going to be a little bit tricky, but I think we can handle it using Onshape and using the rib command in Onshape. So with all that, we've come up with a game plan. Let's get into the software and see how it is done. I'm going to move this drawing over to my second screen so I can follow along with the dimensions. I'm going to create a new document, and I'm going to call this thing egg cover cap. And remember, if you're in Onshape, here, I'll put a TTT in the beginning. You can search this TTT egg cover cap and you can find this document. It is a public document. So if you're using Onshape, if you're using the free version of Onshape, you can just search the public documents and you can find that document. I'm going to start out with a new sketch on the top plane, just like we discussed in our game plan. And I'll start out by creating just a construction line here. So I'll tap Q on my keyboard to give me a construction line. And then I will switch over to the regular line command and create a line that goes over in this direction. This is going to be 75. It's going to be that 150 over 2. Going to come out in this direction. Whoops, we don't want those to be construction anymore. So let me take this line here and press Q again to change that to a solid. And let me jump into a three-point arc command here and create an arc like so. And like I mentioned in the game plan, this is coincident to this line here. So I'll select both of those and press I. I'll jump into the smart dimension and I will give this radius here 160. And then what I can do is I can get into the line command, come back, touch the endpoint. That lets us come off with a nice tangent arc there. And the center of that arc is going to be horizontal to the origin and this point here. So we'll make all of those horizontal with an H command. And then we will create a smart dimension at 125. There we go. As always, getting that first sketch correct is important, so we can take our time a little bit as we're working through that first sketch. Now we can jump into a revolve command, and we're going to revolve using this axis here, and we will take that to a one direction revolve at 180. And that is our first feature, and I think that's looking pretty good. I think for our second feature, what I would do is perform a shell command. And like we talked about in the game plan, I think that what I would do with the shell command is remove both this face and this face, because now I can get into a new sketch on this surface here, and I can create the geometry that I need for that kind of rear cap area. I know that I don't need to convert entities, but as I've discussed before, old habits die hard. So sometimes it's a little bit hard to remember not to convert entities. And so this dimension here from the top is going to be, looks like it's going to be 15, it's kind of dimensioned a little bit weird on the print. It's 45 from the top of that base, which is a total of 15. It's 45 minus 15, so it's 30. So 30 from there, and now we can take that geometry and choose to extrude it. Obviously, it's not going to be the whole thing, but Onshape is smart enough to know to kind of auto-trim. It's one of the things I really like about Onshape is you really don't have to trim. The software just kind of figures it out for you. And that's going to go out to a depth of 6 millimeters as well. All right, that gives us our first couple of features. This thing is looking pretty good. I think what I'm going to do is begin a new sketch here on this surface, and I'm going to create the sketch for that circular boss extrude. So let's get normal to and create our circle. And this circle is going to have a diameter of, just looking at the print again here, 30. And the distance to that circle from the rear of the model is going to be 25. So that really doesn't leave much room for the that wall geometry, huh? If we go there and make that 25, a little bit of room, but it gets pretty snug there. All right, let's turn that into an extrude, and let's say that we want that extrude to go up to next. That'll take it right up to the bottom of the part. All right, I think that's looking pretty good. Oh, you know what though? That extrude, let's double click on that extrude so we can get into the edit extrude feature. That's gonna have a starting offset, and that starting offset is gonna be 15. It's gonna start out 15 above the rest of the model. There we go, it's not gonna be right on. It's gonna be 15 above. Okay, well now that we have that boss, I think we're ready to try to create our rib, and I'm gonna do the rib using the normal two sketch plane option. So that means I'm gonna create the rib here on the front plane. And this rib is going to be created just kind of embedded in the rest of the model. I might even pick up a relationship to that sketch I created a moment ago. This is going to come out about 30 millimeters. Just call it 30. Actually, it's exactly 30 millimeters. And then we're going to run into a tangent arc. And that tangent arc is going to have a dimension of 190. This thing is going to exist. The whole thing here is going to exist slightly below this boss that we created a moment ago, 5 millimeters below this boss. So we'll jump into that dimension command again. And I think what I'll do is I'll show that sketch of the circular boss, and that way I can make this point and this point vertical. So select those two points and press V. And then the last thing I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna create a dimension just to hold this about halfway into the material. And that way, if the egg shape changes at all in the future, it'll be easy for me to make sure that it stays updated and stays in the right spot, the rib. So about halfway into the material there, let's jump out of this sketch. Let's jump into the rib command. And for the rib, we're gonna be using this and this. And this could be parallel to sketch plane. It's gonna be at a wall thickness of 4 millimeters. And let's just make sure that it is going in the correct direction. I think that all looks excellent. Yeah, that looks great. Cool, rib complete. So now for my second rib, what I need to do is create a sketch plane that is really, if the ribs are 4 millimeters, which they are, I need to create a sketch plane here, which is 2 millimeters in this direction so I can get the middle of the rib. So I'm going to take the rearmost face of the model, right mouse button. I'm gonna do offset plane. And it looks like that offset distance is gonna be the 25 to that boss plus an additional 30. So it's gonna be 55 minus 2, so 53. And let's make sure it's going in the correct direction. There we go. I think that looks good. And now I'm gonna select that face and begin a new sketch. We're gonna get normal to that sketch, and we're going to create a line. And this line is going to, really it's gonna be coincident to that other line there. So let's make a line like so. Come off to a tangent arc, and there we go. And this, like I said, is going to be, probably I could make it midpoint, and that would be a nice relationship. It's gonna just kind of drop it right in the middle of that line. So yeah, I like that, that looks good. And now for our dimensions for this arc, it's gonna be 25 off of that center point, and it's gonna have a radius here of 60, all right. And then once again, we just want to kind of take a moment and make sure that this is embedded in that wall. So I'll just kind of eyeball this one up, make sure it's kind of embedded in that wall. And now we're going to go to our rib command again. I love the rib command in Onshape. So we're going to go to the rib command again here. We're going to say it's going to be 4 millimeters, and this one is going to use this profile and this profile. And let's just make sure the direction is correct. Oh yeah, that looks good. cool. All right, let's go to the mirror command and say that we're going to mirror a feature, and that feature is going to be the rib, and the mirror plane is going to be the front plane. And that looks good. And I guess that the final feature that we need to create is just going to be the cut revolve, the counter bore. So we're pretty much done with this thing already. This is nice. So we'll do a new sketch here, and we will get normal two, and we're going to create this counter bore sketch. It's going to start here. It's going to go down to a depth of 75. And then it's going to come out and then down the rest of the way, over and up. And we can close off this sketch, and then we can create another line here, which is going to be a construction line. And that'll let us create some of the remaining geometry here. Let's take this point and just make it midpoint here. That should help us get everything locked down. And then we're going to create a dimension that goes to the center line. Go get that line that goes across. That's going to be 12. And then at the lower section of this counter bore here, we're going to create a double dimension that comes in at 18. And that is looking pretty darn good. Can jump into the revolve. We can say this is our revolve axis. It's going to be a remove. Oh yeah, that's what I like to see. All right, so I'll press letter P here to hide my planes, and I will assign a material to this. So we'll do right mouse button, assign material, and I'm going to get this material from the TTT custom library. It's going to be ABS, and then I am going to, I don't know, just for a flex here, I'm going to go edit appearance and just change this to the same green that the part is. Like I said, you don't have to do that. It's just for a little bit of flex. Let's measure the mass properties down here. And when we get to the mass properties, which is down in the corner, we can see here that the mass of this model is 251.1 grams. Let's stop the clock here at 12:26. Let's go to the end of the model and see if we got it correct. And we did. Oh yeah, we got it, baby. That's what I like to see. So great suggestion, Michael. Thank you so much for asking for that tutorial. I hope that that helps you. Here, I'm going to say that I was able to do it. Was able to do it in Onshape in 12:26. Yeah. So that's going to do it for the egg cover cap tutorial in Onshape. I hope that you guys enjoyed that. Let me know down in the comments what you thought. Did you learn anything new from this tutorial? Or of course, if you see me doing anything that I could be doing more efficiently, please let me know that as well. I've been learning so much by reading through your comments, so please keep the comments coming. They have been so helpful. And of course, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to come back for the next episode. See you, everybody.